What's up, YouTube? It's Fat Dad Skates Bad. Welcome back to the channel. It is like 8 o'clock on a Sunday night. I'm in a new parking lot, so hopefully I don't get kicked out or anything like that. So I'm actually rocking a new pair of New Balances. I don't know if you guys can see them, and I went to the ski park for like 10 minutes today. Skated pretty hard yesterday, but I didn't really film. They felt really like awkward and really like bulky, and I'm super not used to them. But I think tonight we're gonna skate some flat ground, and I'm gonna try for the first time in my life some backside 180s. It's a trick that is super basic that I've been putting off forever. And I don't know if I'm gonna get into any kickflip attempts tonight, but I think tonight we're gonna work on the backside 180 and see if I got anything for it. The only thing I kind of don't like about this like parking lot is like, it's actually kind of cool. We're up on a hill, you got a nice view of like the city in the background, but it's very slanted, so it's gonna be a little bit tough. It's not like flat ground. I think right now we're just gonna warm up on some ollies and yeah, go from there. So stay tuned. Alright guys, those are some terrible ollie attempts tonight. These new shoes, like my timing's all off. But God, they feel good on my feet. I really hope I get used to them. Like those Nikes feel nice, but these things feel like pillows. Like way better. They're the high top New Balance 440s, I think. Super, super digging them. My old man feet are liking them. So anyways, I don't have a lot of time tonight, like always. But we're all about the backside 180. But we're gonna warm up with some frontside 180. So hopefully I don't bust my ass here. This view is just so fucking epic. I really hope I don't get kicked out of here. I don't know if you can see it, but see the whole city, it's fucking cool. But anyways guys, gonna be frontside 180 time, and then we'll try to move into the backside. Ready? All right, let's get it. All right guys, those aren't super pretty, but whatever, Sunday night. back to skating flat ground, so funny. You know what? I think we're gonna do a little bit more warming up. Those ollies felt terrible, but sometimes fakie ollies feel better. So we'll do a quick couple fakie ollies here. And yeah, let's see, let's get it. I thought there was a coyote here. Turns out it's just some dude walking his dog back and forth. It really like tripped me out for a minute. So I could just see this like light colored, super skinny dog staring at me. But yeah, I thought it was pretty funny. But yeah, this place has got like this weird apocalyptic vibe, just cause you're like up on this hill and like the cityscape in the background. It's really epic. But anyways, yeah, so I think we're gonna forego all my really shitty warm-ups and we're gonna try to just get it today. So I heard a helpful thing, I watched some tutorials, is to practice like power slides front side. So we're gonna start off with that. I'm gonna try to get 10 front side power slides, and this ground is actually really good for it. So yeah, let's give it a shot. 10 front side power slides. We'll move on from there. All right, guys, that was kind of fun. I'm very dizzy, but yeah. So I don't know if I should try these stationary, or if I should fucking try and moving. The only thing is, like, this ground doesn't look very slanted, but it's actually quite slanted, and like you gain a ton of speed super fast. But the nice part is it's kind of like one giant bank. So I'm thinking maybe I'll just try the motion still and see if I can kind of get around. And if I don't die doing that, then maybe I'll try it rolling and then going back uphill. So I'll give that a shot. So I'm gonna do stationary attempts right here. So let's go. Alright guys, that was a ton of fucking attempts. Actually went better than I thought. I actually got some. I would say they're probably about a centimeter off the ground, or half an inch for us American folk. But dude, I fucking, not that bad. You really gotta pop, and that's like what I struggle with my 180s, is like I don't pop, I just kind of like muscle through them. And it's kind of just stuck with me. I like it, but I don't get any height, but it just feels so clean when I do it that way. So I was trying to do it with my front side and I would just be all over the place. But as soon as I tried to pop just a tiny bit and then brought those shoulders over, it kind of came together. Didn't land any like super clean ones, but fuck, for that was the first time in my life I ever really tried them. So pretty excited about that. So I'm just gonna add it to the repertoire. Anyways, it's getting late and I was gonna do some kickflip attempts. So maybe we'll do 10. Alright guys, it's steep. We'll do 10 kickflip attempts. And then maybe some nose manuals and we'll be out of here. So yeah, stay tuned. Something new, and it actually kind of went good for once. So for the kickflip attempts, but I don't want to get too heavy back into them. I'm gonna take them slow, just kind of work on it. It killed the fun for me for skateboarding. Like when I force myself to do something over and over and over and over, I get super overwhelming, and I feel like it's on my own mental state that held me back. So I'm gonna just take it easy, but every single time I film, I'm dedicating at least 10 kickflip attempts on video just to say I did it. But yeah, I want to dedicate this video. It's a very lame video, terrible skateboarding, but I want to really dedicate it to Mr. John Hill. I'm very sad that he's stepping away from skateboarding, but I'm excited for his journey, and I just want to say that it's been real. Like, I was watching those guys' videos before I started skating at 35, and it was surreal to have somebody so likable, so laid back and not core and cool, and just have a guy that just loves to skateboard, and just that love and passion in his face I see for his art career. And I think that's dope, man. I want him to follow his heart, And I guess it's just like a message to my kids. Follow your dreams, man. Like, it is what it is. And it's cool to see that he did the skateboard thing. And now he needs to move on to something else. And I think as skaters, we should really respect that and support him in his new endeavor. Just because he's such a rad dude. He's so good at skateboarding. And just the hardest working man in skateboarding, I swear to God. So here's to you, John Hill. I take off my hat. I know you'll never watch this video, but it's okay. And yeah, guys, have a great week up ahead. And I'll definitely get a video out by next week. And I'm going to be posting every single week for anybody that cares. I'll keep it to one video a week, maybe two if I can make it out. Thank you guys so much for watching. And stay tuned and keep bettering yourselves. Thanks, guys. Take care.